In the neighborhood of Abobo, these demolished walls will soon be replaced by the metro of Abidjan. In August, hundreds of people saw their house destroyed. Fazo Manasila is one of them.
Here was the terrace, the living room, from here to there.
Authorities had discussions about the community impact of the project, and most locals agreed to give up their homes in exchange for compensation. But Fazoumana says officials didn't hold up their side of the agreement.
We should have been compensated before being evacuated, but our house has been destroyed, and now we're waiting. It's a really hard situation.
The situation is not unique. In the nearby neighborhood of Anyama, others claim to have gone through the same ordeal. A local NGO has spent years advocating for those who have lost their homes to construction projects in Abidjan. He says that vulnerable residents are likely to fall further into poverty.
They haven't only lost their homes, but also their source of income, because their home was where they made their money.
The Colombivoire organization says that 3 out of 10 people made homeless by the project have been compensated. The government says it's making progress.
In Anyama, we're doing very well. In Abobo, we've done more than 50%. The project in Adjamé is also going forward. But if you have to wait until the last resident leaves the neighborhood before beginning to demolish, well, in 3 years, nothing would have been done.
The government's determined to have the metro constructed by 2025. According to the officials, this project will lead to the destruction of more than 9,000 homes.